Simon, what are key, what are AGEA's key business activities?
Purely focused on the fertiliser sector in Brazil. We have projects on the potash side and the phosphate side of Brazil. And we love Brazil because it's really the agricultural powerhouse of the world, and yet it's very important dependent on these products.
Are there any other attractions to Brazilian phosphate and potash markets?
Look, the attractions over there are that the market is there for us to sell into. So the business model is very simple. We'll explore, develop, sell into the domestic market. I mean, there's a bulk commodities, you need infrastructure and markets, and for us, it's on our doorstep where we're exploring.
What are the key catalysts over the next 6 to 12 months for the company?
We've got a really, really exciting time ahead, next 6 months in particular. We made a discovery on a phosphate project in southern Brazil in November last year, where we initiated a diamond drilling program. We discovered some good grades and thicknesses of phosphate mineralisation on our Tresor Starters project. And we're aiming to have a JORC resource on that this quarter, as well as doing beneficiation test work on the samples this quarter as well. So once we prove we can beneficiate the ore that we've found, we'll then continue to drill the ore body out.
So why should investors look to your company?
Look, it's pretty simple in that we don't have to build railways, we don't have to build ports, we don't have to find off-takers offshore. We've got a very, very proactive government in Brazil who want to become more self-sufficient in fertiliser production. In the next 10 years, they want to become self-sufficient. So for us, there's a lot of hurdles that we don't have to jump because we're already in the place where we're going to sell the product to.
Right. And can you give us an overview of the company's key assets?
Key assets, 4 projects. Three phosphate projects, 1 potash project. Our real focus for the next 6 to 12 months is one of those phosphate projects, which is the Rio Grande area, where we're aiming for our resource. Our other project, Mata da Quarta, we've farmed out to a big Brazilian group who have to spend $7 million there while we have a free carried interest. And our potash project is in the only producing potash basin in Brazil. There's only 1 potash mine in Brazil, a large land holding, but really that'll be probably 12 to 18 months away before we do any further work on that project as we spend our funds on the phosphate project.
You were saying you've got some advantages around infrastructure. Would you like to tell us more about?
Yeah, well, the Tresor Stars project's quite unique in that there's actually a railway running through the project. This railway runs north to ports, Paranagua, which has fertiliser plants, in southern Brazil. It also runs to the south into northern Argentina. It runs into Uruguay as well. So there's several options for us to sell our phosphate rock in that area with the railway there. Because currently most of the rock comes in from Morocco and Algeria into the southern ports of Brazil. So we've got a real freight differential for already being in the country and being able to sell into those areas. So the infrastructure's great, there's plenty of water, there's power on site. So it's a great place to be working.
And is Brazil your most important market, the domestic market there?
Absolutely, yeah. Yep. We're a very proactive government. We get good tax incentives as we move forward. And the Brazilian market, the demand for phosphate is growing at about 4% per annum, compared to the global demand of about 2 to 3%. It really is the agricultural powerhouse of the world. It's the breadbasket of the world. It's all about food. We've got to eat.
And can you give us an overview, please, of the company's management and board?
Yeah, we've got a great team. Our team in Brazil is headed by Dr. Fernando Talarici. He's a Brazilian with a complete Brazilian team. Fernando is a very highly qualified geologist, has come through the Noranda Falconbridge stable of companies and BHP. He's really the driver on the technical side of Brazil. He's got a great team below him, a geologist. We've got an office in Belo Horizonte, which is our main office, and as well as the technical team, we've got some experts on the team. This is a specialised business. On our board, we've got Alan Pickett, who ran British Sulphur Consultants, which was the fertiliser division for CIU for about 15 years. Brings a wealth of experience on our business development and potential off-takers down the track. And on the processing side, we've got some experts on the phosphate side. John Sinden, who's probably the world's leading rock to acid specialist. There's no point having projects that you can't upgrade and can't get into the fertiliser blenders because of contaminants and not being able to beneficiate. So we've got the key bases covered there.
Simon, thank you.
Thank you.